Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You are still watching Creative Business, and we are still talking about information security and many things about, you know, IT that probably we don't know, pero masyado malaking impact sa ating araw-araw na pamumuhay. At nasa studio ang bagong-bagong guest na si Dennis Paul Nino Sanchez. Hi, Dennis.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Dennis is the Chief Information Officer, the highest paid, no way, the non-paid, I don't know, Chief Information Officer of Global Knowledge Management Center. And he is also a certified ethical hacker. Medyo kailangan natin emphasize yung ethical kasi may mga non-ethical. Mm-hmm. Eh. At napakamaraming, sobrang dami na ginagawa itong taong ito. So huwag na natin patagalin. Sir Dennis, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. Thank you for asking.
Yeah, just like Ryan and Lors, you are in this business, IT security.
Mm-hmm.
You're also a nerd.
Yes.
Geek.
Thank you. I'm proud to be a nerd.
But when did you start realizing that you are not a normal human being?
Actually, I think everybody has different interests naman. So sa akin siguro,
yeah, I know,
this came easy lang eh. Like, somehow it came easy, but honestly, hindi talaga yan yung passion ko eh, yung computers. Pero I guess somehow it became easy. Siguro exposure na rin. My parents brought home computers that I could tinker with. And in college naman, my course was computer science from a computer school talaga. So talaga exposure na rin, and whether gusto ko man o hindi, things became natural and then
but
things
became easy. Did they tell you at least an idea na papunta ka sa computer subject or course?
Of course. Siyempre, it's also my choice, di ba? Pero, yun nga, I was also looking into what is the future.
Mm-hmm.
So, alam ko na pag if I'm gonna look for a job, is yung I will easily get employed pagdating ng panahon. So
right. And then your being nerd will pay off.
Yes.
Kasi lang yung makukuha naman.
Actually, to if you look into my history, I'm not really much of a nerd because I'm not really good in school, sa totoo lang. Pero these things came.
I mean, does it really matter if you're good in school?
Well, I guess in some cases, yes.
Look at you.
I tried to study. Okay,
you tried and you did your best.
Yeah. I also, of course, passed my courses in lang. Pero like I said, you know, my objective back then was to be somebody in the future and to be somebody who's needed. So alam ko na people will need IT in the future. So I want to be good at it.
Yeah, I mean, you're able to go to Malaysia, Thailand, Singapore, Indonesia, even in the US. I mean, to these things. I don't know kung tama yung binabasa mo. Tell me something about it.
Yeah, I'm also one of the regional trainers for a company in Malaysia. And what I do there is I teach IT security. Mm-hmm. So I can come in as a consultant if the company needs to know kung paano ba i-secure yung networks nila. Mm-hmm. Or I could come in as a trainer para sa mga estudyante naman na gusto matuto paano ba tong IT or itong technology na to, and how do I secure it?
Right. Sino ang pinaka-secured dito sa mga bansang ito? Philippines, Malaysia, Thailand, Singapore, Indonesia? Or US?
As sa tingin ko, Singapore is one of those that is leading the region.
Sa security.
Okay. So, what is for sure, medyo nahuhuli tayo dito sa Pilipinas. Medyo tayo isa sa mga humahabol.
Really, I mean, considering na marami naman tayo dito mga talents.
Actually, yun nga yung medyo naging problema sa atin. We have a lot of skilled people, pero there's not a lot of, ano ba natin sabihin to? Yung di sila masyadong nakikita na as somebody who is very important.
Hindi nakikita yung relevance nila.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, sooner or later, baka makita nila.
Oo, nangyayari is they actually go to other countries eh. Mm-hmm. Actually, that's why I was one of those people na found that I'm more important pala sa ibang bansa, so that's why I built my career out of the country then. And then I came back to become,
And here you are, one of the, true or false, Chief Information Officer is the highest paid professional in the organization right now. True or false?
I guess it still depends kung ano yung business niyo.
Commissioner Kim Henares is not watching. So tell me.
Bulong ko na lang sa imama. Pero okay, yeah.
I've read that from a newspaper somewhere. in the US and many other advanced regions, chief information officer as the most important part of the business, they really pay so, I mean, pay well, these people so well.
Because the dependency of the business into technology is very high these days.
Oh, hindi ba? I mean, itanggalin mo yung lahat ng emails nila. So, can they survive another day?
Yeah, we don't think so, di ba?
Kasi we don't think so.
Communication is also very important, lalo na sa sales, marketing, where you can gain more revenue, di ba?
I mean, you cannot just go back to the same, you know, Morse code. You cannot go back.
You can't.
So, just cut the internet connection and you're dead. So basically that.
Oo. So ganun lang, paminsan makita mo na it could be that easy kung hindi talaga protected ngayong network nila.
Right.
The whole business can go down, 'di ba? Putulin mo lang yung ano na.
The entire nation can go down. I think the entire world can go down.
Yes.
Kung wala yung mga communications na yan. But as a matter of your advocacy as well in this particular industry, you are actually doing an event this month. So can you tell us more about the event?
So yes, May 23 and 24, we'll have our event called What the Hack. Mm-hmm. Okay, so
What the Hack,
pangalan ng event. And that event, it's not really to teach people how to hack, huh? Pero it will tell people how to secure their systems by first understanding what these hacking activities are. Okay, so andun yung best practices, andun din yung knowledge naman na ano ba talaga yung ginagawa ng mga hackers. Mm-hmm. And then if you can do this to yourself, you can prove that your system is safe or secure. So there's a lot of businesses here that don't really take this much importance, or they don't think that this is very important. Mm-hmm. Or also we want to cater to those people in the government to be aware. Na kasi alam mo na, the past few days, ang dami natin mga news about websites getting hacked, mga government sites natin na de-deface, di ba, ganyan. And
they are not paying well, the IT. I mean, they should we have a lot of talents if they can just make use of these talents, I mean, for their good and the good of the government, I think they will do so well.
Yeah. Actually, the truth is aware na tayo, aware na yung mga yung government natin, no? Siguro it's now the time to move forward na. Kasi we've been doing this awareness program for about 5 years now.
No,
so parang napapansin nga natin parang hindi nagmo-move forward. Pero yes, this is what also one thing that we will showcase on the events. We have people from AFP,
okay,
PNP, NBI and Department of Justice. They will come and share with the other people. Ano ba yung ginagawa na ng government natin? So parang hindi rin man sumama yung tingin ng mga tao, wala mang ginagawa yung government natin eh. And then, they will be also open to suggestions and also open to learning new stuff. So, the whole event is like not just a place for you to learn new things, right, but also to know
contribute.
Know who's who and contribute to them if you have something that, you know, is worth for them to learn too.
So, as an IT expert, kung hingi ng government ang service mo, would you give it to them?
Honestly, I'm already
doing
some consultation for some of our government offices.
And I'm sure, syempre may ano yan, syempre hindi yan yung paid as in paid na paid, because they are government. Yeah, we know that. The question is, yung mga talents na kagaya mo, are they also willing to contribute their peace of mind and talent and skill when the government asks for it?
I think there's a lot of people that are willing to share, you know. The thing is,
they're not
siguro
willing to ask.
Oh, yun, kasi you can't give if they don't ask for it sometimes. Ang hirap naman mag-offer na kaya ko tong gawin eh.
Pero, yes, it will look suspicious, you know. Why are you helping me? Diba,
pwedeng maging ganun ang dating. Kaya, pero yun nga eh, it starts with awareness and a continuing program to keep evolving or keep educating your people and your team. So, yun yung gagawin natin sa event. Get all these people together, understand what's going on, ano ba yung mga suggestions nyo. And then at the same time, meron kaming mga mini courses to teach different levels. Like if you're just a student, you can learn it from a student's perspective. If you're just a normal user, we can teach you how to secure your usage, kunyari Facebook mo, Twitter mo, yung email mo. And then we also have high levels, gaya nga ng we get to teach ethical hacking, penetration testing, and for those business owners, decision makers, how does it, what is the formula on making IT security something that you can actually have return on your investment?
Kasi many small businesses may probably see it like, ay nako, expense yan. Mm-hmm. Ay nako, gastos yan. Mm-hmm. I would rather invest this dun sa ibang part ng business kaysa dun sa IT. So, they really don't take it so seriously pagdating dun sa prioritization ng kanilang budget.
Well, it's sometimes understandable na bakit nga naman, kasi sometimes you wanna earn first before you can, di ba, bago gumastos. Mm-hmm. Kailangan may kikitain ka muna para may pampanggastos ka. Pero ang problema dun, we forget about the future na what if sayang, nasayang lang lahat ng pinaghirapan mo.
IT-wise, na-wipe out.
Oo, na-wipe out na. Nakuha na lahat ng information mo na sinisekreto mo. Or pwedeng kasi, as in simple lang, di ba, pag hinack yung website mo at nilagyan nila ng pangit na information dyan, sabi ng mga tao.
Kaya kabalik na lang, di ba?
Oo. Yeah, oo, sabi, ang pangit naman itong kumpanya na ito, ang dali nila ma-hack.
Di ba? Our company is the worst company.
So, bakit kami mag-invest sa'yo? So, talo rin yung business mo, di ba? So,
nakalagay ito, never contact us. Instead of contact us.
Oo nga, no?
Pwede. They can do that. But how much are we talking about kung small business ako, I'm earning probably less than 2 million a year. Sole proprietor business, non-VAT, I want to secure my very little IT, you know, emails or website. How much do I need to spend or invest?
So ganito yon, no? For you to actually know how much, it's actually there's a computation or calculation on how much you make. Kasi dun mo rin malalaman kung gaano ba ka-importante o gaano ba ka-critical yung mga assets na pinoprotektahan mo.
So say 1.9 million, that's what I earn for a year.
Okay.
Sa sole proprietor business ko. Pero syempre, gumagamit ako ng email araw-araw, may website ako. You know, how much
will sige, pay? So medyo magsalita ako ng konting math, habulin niyo na lang ako.
Sige.
It's a calculation of risk. So risk is equal to the asset value times how many threats do you have and how many vulnerabilities.
Dennis, I don't know what the threats are. I don't know what the hell is this.
Here comes the first thing, and it may come free, it may come at a price. Education. You need to first know what is this that you're dealing with.
All right, Dennis, I am a business person. I don't want to learn about it. I don't have the time. I just need probably you or like you. How much do I pay the guy?
How much do I, again, magkano ba yung, gito ah.
So, do I retain you 3,000 a month? 5,000 a month?
If you have 1.9 million per year, then you might want to give me 10%, but then I can make sure that next year you'll earn another 1.9.
Okay, so 190.
That's a rough estimate, huh? So I'm saying that it could actually get higher depending on yung...
Get higher!
Kasi, let's say, kunwari, ikaw si eBay, ikaw si Amazon, wala kang mang tindahan eh, di ba? Yung website mo lang. So, I'm your best friend.
Okay.
So, di ba? Yeah. So, totoo lang. And then also, my job is gonna be very hard. Baka hindi na ako matutulog niyan to protect your...
Yeah, I don't think makakatulog ka pa because, you know, that kind of infrastructure, di ba? Paano mo siya ma-maintain?
But the idea is nga, there's gonna be a computation and how much you earn and how much you will invest on security.
So, part of your assessment job yon. I mean, tingnan din. Kasi nga, ako bilang isang maliit na negosyante, meron na ako information system. Ah, di ba, ako pa ba mag-identify kung sino yung threat? Ako pa ba? Kasi I don't want to wake up one day na sira na yung aking maliit na infrastructure.
So
pero may mas mura sa'yo, no?
Oh, so you can actually call them. Ito lang muna, ganito lang yun eh. You gotta learn. So you gotta start small, you gotta study. Okay, you can look it up on your own. But if you think this is something new, then you enroll yourself in a course like, yun nga, being a secured user. Hindi naman yung ganang kamahal. Okay, on our event, by the way, we'll be giving it at a very low price. Sabi nga namin for students nga, it's 780, is that correct? 785 pesos lang. So this...
Saan mapupunta yung 5 pesos? Bakit may putal na 5 pesos?
Hindi ko alam, paano nila kinumpit yan. Baka sa akin mapupunta. Anyway, pero the idea is this course allows you or gives you the knowledge na to be competitive.
Okay. So, at least meron sila pupuntahan. So, contact details, kung gusto ko nilang makontakt, yung regarding sa event, ano yung tatawagan nila?
So they can contact our office 721-4380 sa Global Knowledge, and our website is www.gkphilippines.com.
Okay? Okay, gkphilippines.com.
Yes.
Okay.
So, yan.
So, thank you so much, Dennis, for your time. This is an amazing conversation. I will look forward to another of this kind.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much. So, May 23
and 24 is a two-day event.
Two-day event, saan yan?
Sa SM Aura.
SM Aura. Okay, so punta kayo dyan, What the Hack. Another episode of Creative Business. I'm going to see you again next week, everyone. Bye!